Well, the news that came in last evening, Ratan Tata is no more. The chairman of Tata Sons and one of the most towering figures in Indian businesses has passed away on Wednesday night in Mumbai's Breach Candy Hospital at the age of 86. Reports say that he was in a critical condition and was under intensive care. His death that was announced by N. Chandrasekharan, the chairman of Tata Sons, who hailed the industrialist's unwavering commitment to excellence, integrity and also innovation. In a statement, he called Ratan Tata a truly uncommon leader whose immeasurable contributions have shaped not only Tata Group, but also the very fabric of our nation. Ratan Tata, who leaves behind a profound legacy of business leadership and a deep commitment to societal betterment, given how he reportedly also donated majority of his income to charitable causes. It was back in the year 2008 when Ratan Tata received the Padma Vibhushan, the second highest civilian honor in India, after receiving the Padma Bhushan, the third highest civilian honor in the year 2000. Let's quickly get in a word from Anurag. He's joining us right outside the residence of Ratan Tata in Kolaba in South Bombay. We have Anurag as far as top leaders who are expressing their condolences. And of course, there would be some time that would be given for his family to pay their last tributes before the mortal remains are moved.
Tributes are pouring in for the patriarch of India's biggest business group, the Tata Group, Ratan Tata. Just now, Sachin Tendulkar paid his last tributes to Mr. Ratan Tata. And if you can see, this is the neighborhood in South Mumbai. This is the Bhaktawar building in Kolaba Causeway. And Mr. Ratan Tata stayed here for most of his life. And there is a lot of crowd around, and it's expected that his mortal remains will be moved to NCPA. That should happen by around 10:30, and following that, at around 4 p.m., his body would be moved to the Wadli Crematorium, where the last rites would be performed.
Absolutely, as Ratan Tata's mortal remains will also be kept at the NCPA, which is the National Center for Performing Arts in South Mumbai. And Arunil, we believe the mortal remains will remain there from 10 to 4 p.m. before it is moved for last rites.
Well, that is right, Amita. Behind me are the elaborate preparations that have been made. You can see representatives of the Tata Group also over here. At around 10:30 a.m., the mortal remains of Mr. Ratan Tata will be brought here at the NCPA. The followers or the fans of Mr. Ratan Tata can pay their last respects to the legendary man. His legacy continues. Speaking about several anecdotes related to Mr. Ratan Tata. Everybody in India probably has a story, particularly people living in South Mumbai have their story related to the legendary man. In fact,
absolutely. As Arunil was pointing out, there are stories and innumerable stories that can actually one think of or remember when it comes to the humility and with the one of the hardest farewells that one has to give to Ratan Naval Tata, who was truly an uncommon leader. And of course, when it comes to the immeasurable contributions that he has made, Anurag, that has not only shaped the Tata Group, but also when it comes to the very fabric of our nation. Arunil, if you can take that question, as you were talking about how the people today are remembering Ratan Tata.
Well, Ratan Tata is not only about business leadership. Certainly, yes, he was a business magnate, somebody who took over the Tata Group in 1991, from salt to steel to software. Everything the Tata Group basically specialized in, giving jobs to more than 30 lakh people are presently employed with the Tata Group. But he's primarily also about how a business tycoon should behave, how he felt for his country and what he did for his countrymen. Several such incidents. If I have to speak about it, whenever I saw Ratan Tata, he basically, what was interesting to note about him was he always sat next to his driver. That basically showcased his humility. Whenever he went went to the Tata office. He got down without any big security. He played with the street dogs nearby. In fact, at the Bombay House as well, there is a shelter home that has been made for the street dogs, wherein appropriate and latest facilities are being provided to street dogs as well. His love for pet dogs is also very well known. In fact, his friendship with a young general manager from the Tata Group only, Mr. Naidu, S. Naidu, is also very well known. How Naidu had basically initiated a project to save the street dogs from road accidents, that basically impressed Ratan Tata, and then their basically bonding started. Ratan Tata, in fact, invested in his venture as well. Speaking about Ratan Tata, several such incidents clearly come to the fore. As a sports journalist, whenever I used to go to the Cooperage ground as well, a renowned football ground, Ratan Tata could be seen over there sitting on the last chairs, enjoying a local football match. That was his motivation for the local football players, away from any kind of limelight. That has been tweeted by Clyde Trasto as well, another South Mumbai resident and obviously a political leader. Ratan Tata, who started his journey with the Tata Group at a very ordinary position, he basically behaved as a common man. But when basically he became the legend that he was during the COVID pandemic as well, he had urged all other business leaders as well as company owners not to lay off their employees, because he knew that this was a difficult period for his fellow countrymen. Speaking about the 2611 horrific attacks as well, Ratan Tata personally went and met the family members of the victims of the family. Basically, he contributed financially, giving aid to the victims as well. So that kind of feeling, that sentiment that Ratan Tata,
I think there could be many of those incidents that one can fondly remember Ratan Tata, Runil, because as you were mentioning, when his work that especially comes to the dogs or even for animals, his dedication for the welfare of animals, because many may not know about an incident when he turned down a prestigious honor from the UK royal family, and there was a lifetime achievement award that was to be honored with as far as Ratan Tata being concerned, and he cancelled his plans last minute. The reason that his dog had fallen seriously ill and he chose to stay back to take care of his furry friend rather than attend the royal ceremony. I mean, this is just one of the many stories that we can actually talk about all day about Ratan Tata. But being a visionary and a man who is not only known for his work for the nation, but for the fellow countrymen, for his global achievements, right from salt to steel to software to automobiles to aviation, he has molded the Tata Group in his own image over the last many decades. So when it comes to the growth of India, that was seen simultaneously with the group, or with the growth of Tata Group.
A visionary business leader, a compassionate soul, an extraordinary human being. That is how Prime Minister Narendra Modi described business tycoon Ratan Tata in his tribute. But this man's legacy goes much beyond these words. He was a man with a vision and the grit to realize it too. Wednesday, this visionary breathed his last. The former chairman of diversified Tata Group and a towering figure in Indian business passed away at the age of 86. Born in Navsari, Gujarat, Tata was the great-grandson of Jamshedji Tata, the founder of Tata Group, and he stirred the conglomerate to unprecedented heights. Tata took the reins of Tata Group in 1991, coinciding with a period of economic liberalization in India. Over his two-decade-long leadership, he oversaw the diversification and expansion of the group into sectors like IT, steel, automobiles, and hospitality. The introduction of Tata Nano, an affordable four-wheeler for the masses, was one of his signature accomplishments. And in a rare interaction with Group Editor-in-Chief Navika Kumar, he detailed the challenges faced in the pursuit.
Mr. Tata, you spoke about being caught in the political crossfire. But we in India have known about corporate rivalries as well. They've been age-old in this country. What do you think really happened? Political crossfire or corporate rivalries?
Certainly there was political crossfire. There's no doubt about that. That was out in the open. And I think it's an unfortunate crossfire because I think the nano project can come and go many times in a state. But what does happen is a state like West Bengal requires to rebuild the confidence of investors again, and each one of such events detracts from that. As far as corporate rivalry is concerned, there has been from time to time statements from various sources of involvement in these affairs of fueling the flames or funding the activity by vested interests. They may be corporate rivals, or they may be vested interests of one sort or another. And India is a place where this happens, where people stoop to tremendous depths to live with the protection of days gone by.
There were also several key global acquisitions, including Tetley, Jaguar Land Rover and Chorus, that happened under his guidance. And it wasn't just business acumen. Ratan Tata was also known for his philanthropy. Over 65% of his shares in Tata Sons go to charitable causes. His contributions have funded education, healthcare and social development projects across the country. In his passing away, India might have lost a titan, but legends like Ratan Tata never fade away.
So his contributions are innumerable, right from education to healthcare, his initiatives that have left a deep-rooted mark that will benefit generations to come, as he is fondly remembered. Hina also joining in because, Hina, as the news spread, tributes have been pouring in from his friends, from fellow industrialists, from film stars, from politicians everywhere.
Well, that's right. There is almost every industry that Ratan Tata had a role to play in. And that's the reason why tributes have been pouring in from across the world, be it from the world of sports, cinema, industry, or from the world of politics. And we would like to show you some of those that have come in so far. And I'd like to begin with Anand Mahindra, Chairman Mahindra Group. And here's what he has said. I am unable to accept the absence of Ratan Tata. India's economy stands on the cusp of a historic leap forward, and Ratan's life and work have had much to do with our being in this position. Hence, his mentorship and guidance at this point in time would have been invaluable. With him gone, all we can do is to commit to emulating his example, because he was a businessman for whom financial wealth and success was most useful when it was put to the service of the global community. Goodbye and Godspeed, Mr. T. You will not be forgotten, because legends never die. Om Shanti. And like I mentioned, it's not just, from people from the industry, people from India Inc., but across the world, people are sharing their feelings and emotions at this point in time. Here we have Sundar Pichai, CEO of Google, who has also put out a tweet saying, "My last meeting with Ratan Tata at Google, we talked about the progress of Waymo, and his vision was inspiring to hear. He leaves an extraordinary business and philanthropic legacy and was instrumental in mentoring and developing the modern business leadership in India. He deeply cared about making India better. Deep condolences to his loved ones." Then we have people from the world of film fraternity, people from the world of film also reacting to what has happened, what has actually come in as a huge shock to many, and people are expressing their emotions. We have Rajmouli, the famous director, saying, "Legends are born and they live forever. It's hard to imagine a day without using a Tata product." Now that's a fitting tribute, because on a daily basis we all use a Tata product in some way or the other. He says, "Ratan Tata's legacy is woven into everyday life. If anyone will stand the test of time alongside the Panchabhutas, it is him. Thank you, sir, for everything you've done for India and for impacting countless lives. And then we have, at the same time, Anupam Kher also reacting, also, you know, expressing his emotions on social media platform X. He says, goodbye, Mr. Tata. Thank you for your life and your life lessons. Thank you for leaving behind a legacy, not only for India, but for the entire world. A legacy of honesty, hard work, integrity, kindness, patriotism, gentleness, generosity, compassion and pride. And he has also, as a tribute, has put out this video for Ratan Tata, and he says, you will always remain my most favorite goat, the greatest of all times, Jai Ho. I would also like to quickly take you through another post by Akshay Kumar, the actor, who says, the world bids farewell to a man who built more than just an empire. Heartbroken to hear about the passing of Sri Ratan Tata, his legacy of kindness, innovation and leadership will continue to inspire generations. And one more before I hand it back to you. From the world of sports, we have Rohit Sharma also expressing his emotions on social media. He has put this picture of Ratan Tata, and he says, a man with a heart of gold. Sir, you will forever be remembered as someone who truly cared and lived his life to make everyone else's better. So that's the emotion that people are expressing, that he lived, you know, for just to ensure that everybody lives comfortably. And like one of them said, the Tata product is something that we all use in some way or the other, and that's the reason why we have emotions pouring in from across the world, from across the quarters.
Absolutely, and that was the confidence there as far as the products that everyone that has been using, and how his life has been an inspiration to many. In a series of also posts that Prime Minister Narendra Modi, along with many of those pictures that the Prime Minister shared, saying that how he provided with a stable leadership to one of India's oldest and the most prestigious business houses. And at the same time, his contribution that went far and beyond from the boardroom. Mr. Niranjan Hiranandani is with us on the phone line. Sir, well, today we're all waking up. Unfortunately, the news that came in late last evening, but Ratan Tata, the veteran industrialist, is no more.
Yes, it's a very, very, very sad day for our country. A great human being, a great human being first, a great human being last, great leadership in industry and business. But I think the ethical values and the human being in Ratan Tata is celebrated as much as his success in business. I think the two elements are together in one human being, a rarity on me. On button. Yeah, yes. A rarity of a human being.
And Mr. Hiranandani, because the work and the innumerable contributions that has been made by Mr. Ratan Tata, that needs to be hailed on every account for being a compassionate soul, for providing stable leadership, and as we talk about one of the oldest business houses in the country.
I think you're absolutely right. 60% of Tata House is owned by Tata Trust. So obviously, the empathical values are ingrained in the entire edifice of the Tata Group. But that apart, leadership actually changes a person. People who sit in the seat of power, people who sit in the seat of wealth, people who sit in the seat of position, become arrogant. This man was not arrogant. He was actually the opposite. He was humble. He was kind. He was human. You know, the story of Mr. Ratan Tata in 2018 was to be awarded by Prince Charles.
Yes.
An award in philanthropy.
Yes.
And he did not go for the function simply because his dog was unwell.
Yes.
I mean, something of a person which qualifies him as a different human being. Very, very few people would do that, especially when the thing comes and honor is from royalty. You would leave everything and even your near and dear ones. But here, he would not leave his own dog.
Absolutely. And that is probably the kind of impact that he left behind. I mean, many of those people who may not know him directly or would have never met him still remember him fondly, because he will always be an inspiration to the next generation when it comes to entrepreneurs and businessmen. Thank you very much, Mr. Niranjan Hiranandani, for joining in and for paying your tributes. We head into a short break right now. You're watching The